Good morning, students. How are you all? We are back again with a new morning, and I hope you people are safe and sound at your home and are maintaining proper rules and regulations of this lockdown. We will start from where we left, and we'll be doing or completing our chapter 5 from your book, that is separation of substances, right? So let's start with the explanation part, and then we'll finish it off with the question answers in the next week, right? The portion from where we will start is separation of insoluble solids from liquids, and here we will see how some insoluble solids are separated from liquid, and there are methods by which we can do this, and the methods are sedimentation and decantation. Now, sedimentation and decantation is generally used for separating coarse particles, like not very fine particle, of a solid from a liquid which are insoluble in the liquid, because they are not very fine, or else it will be impossible to separate them. They are coarse particle. For example, the coarse particles of sand in muddy water. In muddy water, there is soil, some amount of, which is of course soluble in any liquid or in the liquid, but the coarse particles of sand, they are insoluble, and they can be separated by this decantation method. Before cooking rice pulses, etc., they are washed with water. Now this wash water is removed by decantation method. Just decantation, like when our mother washes the rice or pulses in water, okay, after that they are draining the water, the washed water, that is decantation process, okay. Now a small activity has been given in your book, where this shows to obtain clear water from muddy water with the help of method sedimentation and decantation. So what is the procedure? We'll see. Take small amount of muddy water. So they have taken muddy water in a beaker, and this muddy water is actually a mixture of sand and water. Now we will allow it to stand for some time, and we will see that the particles of sand settle down. The sand particles, they settle down to the bottom of the beaker. Okay, this settling down of heavier particles, because we know the heavier particles will go down, so the heavier particle here is settling down, and this process is called sedimentation. Now after the settlement, the clear water which is above, that is transferred. So transfer the clear supernatant water. What is supernatant water? The water which is on the above, that is the upper layer of water, that is supernatant water, and that is transferred carefully to another beaker. This process of separating clear liquid. So here what we are doing, we are, as the coarse particle settles down over here, okay, then there are fine particles, and then there is a layer of clear water. So this clear water is separated again or transferred in a different beaker. So this process of separating clear liquid without disturbing the settled solid particle is called decantation method. Okay, so here you can see over here, the sediments are here in the beaker at the bottom, okay, and with the help of a glass rod in another beaker, the clear water is just poured into it. Why the glass rod is used? Nothing but to give the flow, to give the liquid a good flow, or else it will just sprinkle or disturb this water also. That is why. So this is how we can see that the clear water is again separated from the muddy water by the process of sedimentation and decantation. Now during sedimentation and decantation class, we will also study one thing, that is a loading method. Now what is loading? During sedimentation, the heavier coarse particles settle down quickly. That is obvious. Fine particles are also present. They settle down a bit slowly. The finer particles can be made to settle faster by dissolving a small quantity of alum in muddy water. Now, how can the fine particles, that is the middle layer, can be made to dissolve faster? Nothing but if we add a small quantity of alum in muddy water. And this method is called loading method. Now, what happens is actually, you can see over here, muddy water, which is having finer particles, it remains floating. Now, alum is dissolved in water, which is tied into a rope and is dropped into the water. Then we will see the finer particles which are present also gradually settles down. So you can see the coarse particle as well as the finer particles are settling down faster. What happens is when alum is added to muddy water, the final particles, they get loaded with alum particles. Okay, the alum particles stick to the finer particles and they form larger aggregates. So larger aggregates and they are formed and they become heavy. So when they become heavy, they will gradually come down and settle at the bottom. So this makes them to settle down faster. So this is actually the process why alum is added and how the loading method takes place. I hope you are able to understand, class. The next method of separating insoluble solid from liquid is the filtration method. And this is a very easy process which we see every day, because whenever tea leaves are retained by the tea strainer, that is when we are straining the tea leaves, that is actually the method of filtration. And here what happens, it is basically used for separating fine insoluble solid particles. In the previous case, we have seen the coarse particles, that is not very fine particle. Here the particles are a bit smaller in size, so we can say fine insoluble solid particles, they can be separated from the liquid. And what is done, first of all, the mixture is allowed to pass through a filter. So a filter is used, as you can see over here in this picture, there is a filter used here. Okay, this is a filter which is being used. So this filter here acts as the retainer, so this will retain the fine particles from the muddy water and allow the clear water to go into the beaker. So this is the clear water or the filtrate, which is basically poured through the strainer, and the strainer keeps the residue, which is the insoluble components, and allows the clear water or the filtrate to pass through it. Okay, a filter is a medium with fine pores, which we see in case of a tea strainer. It is a medium with fine pores. The insoluble solid particles are retained by the filter and the clear liquid is collected as the filtrate. So commonly used filters are a piece of muslin cloth. There is a piece of cloth which is known as which is a muslin cloth actually, and that is used in many laboratories as filter paper, and also filter paper which we will see in our practical labs and laboratories. These round pieces of paper are filter paper. They are very good filtrating or in taking the residue particles or the fine insoluble particles within them and allowing the water to pass through it. A layer of cotton or a layer of riverbed sand can also be used as filter. Nowadays, special filters are used to obtain high purity drinking water. In filtration, what happens? The size of the pores in the filter is very important, because it will allow, whatever the size of the pore is, it will not allow the bigger particles to grow through it. Okay? For a good filtration, the pores in the filter should be smaller than the size of the particles to be removed. Whatever size of the particle we want to remove, the pores in the filter should be smaller than that. Setting of a filter in the funnel is shown over here. If we want to set up a filter paper, so this is a filter paper. This is round, then it is a first fold is given to it. Then again a second fold, this one. And then what happens, just an area is made so that we can see this circle from here. This circular part, it is opened. Okay, so that this cone of filter paper is created and then it is placed into the funnel. And this is how a filter paper is used. Next method is the churning method. This method is used for separating lighter particles of a solid suspended in a liquid. For example, butter. It can be obtained by churning curd. Okay, if we churn curd continuously, what happens? Butter is obtained from it. This lady over here, she is separating butter from milk at home. If we also churn milk for a very long time at home, butter, we will see, comes as the topmost layer. Cream is also obtained from unboiled milk by churning. So in this case, unboiled milk is required. And if we have a churner, or if you have a what you can say, if you have a blender, so if we blend them, cream is created or it is formed. Churning can be done by hand using a stirrer. Hand using a stirrer is a tough part, a tough job, because it takes a lot of time, or by using a mixture commonly called mixie, right?